believe. In this play, done by the 8th grade drama class, we want to show you what it truly means to know what magic is. It all happened on a quiet street in Bloomsbury. That corner house over there is the home of the Darling family. And Peter Pan chose this house because there are people who believed in him. There was Mrs. Darling. Mrs. Darling believed Peter Pan was the spirit of youth. And there was Mr. Darling. Mr. Darling was a practical man. But the children, Michael and Jamie, believed Peter Pan was real and made him the hero of all of their nursery games.
Darn you, Peter Pan, take that! Give up, Captain Hook! Surrender! Never! I'll teach you from cutting off my hair!
No, Jamie, it was the right hand.
All right, thanks, Wendy.
Wendy, the oldest child, not only believed she was the expert on Peter Pan, but all of his marvelous adventures as well.
Oh, Nana, as we always take this nasty tonic.
Nana, the nursemaid, being a dog, kept her opinions to herself and viewed the whole situation with tolerance.
Take that! It's a boy! I'll snap it in the ribbon and I'll cut you to pieces! Aha! Ouch! Careful, but I pulled my glasses. I'm sorry, Jamie. You're gonna make me drink a lot. Oh, yes, I will! Take that! Don't need more for it. I'll show you a throat.
George, do you think the children will be safe without Nana?
Safe? Why not safe? Why not?
Well, Wendy said something about a shadow.
A shadow? Whose shadow?
Peter Pan's.
Peter Pan's? Goodness gracious, what should we do?
But George!
No, really, sound the alarm. Call the police. Oh, Mary, of all the impossible challenge thing for Peter Pan.
There must have been someone. Now, as the children were laying in bed, with the fairy tales Wendy had told them floating in their heads, there was a visitor standing by the windowsill, peering in carefully. Nothing but the moon and the stars lit the room, and the lights in the houses were slowly going out as well.
Take orders.
one.
Watch out! Quick, take me and the children to the island. I'll stay here and draw her.
being quite rude to her guests, and she immediately went off to get the Lost Boys on her side of the argument. Luckily for her, she knew the Lost Boys would listen to whatever Peter had to say.
Yeah. losers.
Sometime you win, sometime we win.
Okay, Chief, you win this time. Now turn us loose.
Turn us loose? You mean it's only a game?
Sir, when we win, we turn them loose. When they win, they turn them loose.
Turn us loose. This time, no turn them loose. The Chief's a great spoofer, a mean old spoofer. Now tell me where you hired Mrs. Tiger Lily.
Tiger Lily?
We ain't got
your old
I'm certain
we've
never seen her.
Big, big lie. Bring Mrs. Tiger Lily back by sunset or burn at stake.
Come back here!
After that catastrophe, Hook and Smee quickly return to the ship, where the rest of the crew helped Smee nurse the captain back to health as he caught a rather horrid cold.
That just puts a pen. Make you a fool of me. Oh, my head.
Oh, a pirate's life is a wonderful life. Your hot water, Mr. Smee.
Shh. We mustn't annoy Peter. We mustn't annoy the Captain Hook. Oh, Captain. Oh, Captain. Oh, why don't we put to sea again? We have a brewing problem here. Why don't we? Oh. Why you told me, Mitchell? Did you say that pen has vanished in the air? Yes, Captain, that I did.
But why?
Well, according to it, Tink tried to kill her. She did.
When?
Oh, we got to leave here. This ain't a good place for respectful pirates such as ourselves.
That's it.
I'm glad you agreed, sir.
Quick, my coat. Bring me my best dress coat.
Aye, sir.
Ah, yes. A chair is connected between into anything. My casual hook, give it to me.
Aye, sir. Here's your Sunday set, sir.
If we impress the Pinksy, convince her we are eager to help her, she may plot our course to a certain hiding place.
Oh, our best hiding place is in Spanish Main, sir. I'll set the course.
And where do you think you're going, Mrs. Smee?
To tell the crews that we're traveling with the tides, sir?
You will go ashore, pick up Tinkerbell, and bring her to me. Understand?
on the other side of the island, where the waves harshly crashed onto the shore, Tinkerbell was waiting for something that even she didn't know. Hook's ship could be seen on the horizon, but the little fairy's attention was quickly stolen away by a problem that was much closer than she would have expected.
Begging your pardon, Miss Bell, but Captain Hook wants a word with you.
Yes, Miss Bell. Captain Hook has missed his defense. Tomorrow, we leave the island, never to return.
I'm glad to hear that. I'll tell the other crews that.
You see, we left a present for Peter, a sort of surprise package, you might say. Where I can see our little friend at this very moment, reading our love label message. Within the package, he will find an ingenious little device set, so when the o'clock is just at 6, Peter Pan will be blasted out of Neverland forever. But what this, my dear? Tears? Then, it is true. Oh, sweet. The way of man with a maid, taking the best year of her life and then tossing her aside like an old glove. But how? We have so little time. We sail in the morning. Say? That suits me. We will Shanghai Wendy.
Shanghai Wendy, Captain?
Take her to sea with us. With her gun. Peter will soon forget this mad infatuation. Come on. We must leave immediately.
But
she runs to Peter's home.
But we don't know where Peter Pan lives.
Great Scott, you're right, me. But what that's, my dear? You could show us the way? Then why didn't you think of that earlier? So, take this down, Smee.
Take this down, Smee. Aye, Captain.
Start at Piglet Point.
Start at Piglet Point.
40 paces west of Blindland's Bluff.
Blindland's Bluff.
And yes, a hop, skip, and a jump across Crocodile Creek. Then north by northeast. 1, 2, 3. Wait, get on with it! Sorry, my dear. Please continue. What? I mustn't harm Peter? My dear, Captain Hook gives his word to not lay a finger or a hook on Peter. Herman's tree. So that's the entrance of his hiding place. Thank you, my dear. You have been most helpful.
Big Chief greets little mother. How?
Oh, other.
Did he have something he doesn't want to find out?
No, that was Nana.
You better fly away like a crow. You're a crowdly sparrow.
No, but-
Let's have it now. Prepare to die in silence.
She is still a child. Wendy, what in the world are you doing there?
Oh, mother, we're back. Yes, also the Lost Boys. Day one, quite ready.
Lost Boys, ready.
Yeah, to go up. That's why you went back to Neverland.
Neverland?
Yes, but I am ready to go up.
Well, it's your own good time. After all,
oh, my mother, it was such a wonderful adventure. Tinker Bell and Peter Pan. Oh, he was the most wonderful of all. Even when we were kidnapped, I knew he would save us, and he did. And I called him a codfish. Oh, Captain Hook, I mean. And we sailed away on a ship in the sky.
Mary, I'm going to bed.
Oh, mother, he really is wonderful. See how he sails the ship.
George, how about Mary? Now that you can see, you know, I had a strange feeling myself at this long ago, back when I was still a child.
George, dear.
Daddy.
Thank you.
In the star-painted night sky, the adventure with Peter Pan in Neverland was never truly forgotten. Even now, if you look at the starry night sky, maybe, just maybe, you'll see the ship sailing between the clouds, and you'll know deep down that Peter Pan may have gotten a happy ending as well.